What's going on, everyone? Welcome to another KeyShot quick tip. In this video, I'll be giving you a quick look at KeyShot's depth of field camera settings and showing you how you can use this awesome tool to add realism and drama to your KeyShot renderings. If you're looking for a quick and hassle-free way of adding drama to your scenes, a great way to do that would be to use KeyShot's depth of field settings located in the camera tab of the project panel. Just below the lens settings and stereo settings accordions, you'll find the depth of field accordion. With this accordion open, you'll notice two settings that appear grayed out until the checkbox is toggled on. If you're familiar with cameras and photography, then these two settings should be very familiar and intuitive for you to use. For those of you that aren't familiar with depth of field, let's take a quick look at what it is and how you can use it. In its most basic sense, depth of field is the zone of acceptable sharpness within an image that appears in focus. This zone varies from photo to photo. Some have a very small zone of focus, which is known as shallow depth of field, while others may have a large zone of focus, which is known as a deep depth of field. Essentially, there are three main factors that control your depth of field effects: distance from subject, focal length, and f-stop, all of which can be controlled straight from the camera tab within KeyShot. To get started, you'll want to adjust your camera's view to frame your subject in the desired manner. You can either do this with your mouse by clicking, dragging, and using the scroll wheel to zoom in and out, or by manipulating the position and orientation sliders in the camera tab until your camera is in the preferred position. Once your orientation is set, toggle the depth of field parameters on by selecting the checkbox at the top of the accordion. You can then adjust your focal distance by using the parameter slider, or by selecting the target icon and then left-clicking the point on your model or in your scene that you'd like to focus on. I would highly recommend using the click method when selecting your focal point, simply for the sake of building a more efficient workflow. From here, you'll want to adjust your f-stop to a value that gives you the desired amount of focus and sharpness. Typically, the closer your subject is, the lower an f-stop number you can work with. The ideal f-stop value will also depend on whether you are going for a shallow depth of field effect or a deeper depth of field. Using depth of field settings not only helps isolate your subject, creating a focused point of interest, but they can also help you draw attention to specific features or design elements, as well as provide a means to create dramatic effects such as bokeh within your KeyShot scenes. Thanks for watching this KeyShot quick tip. If you're interested in more useful KeyShot content, hit that subscribe button and get notified as soon as new videos hit the channel. Don't forget to let us know your thoughts on this tutorial in the comment section below, and if you found this video useful, give it a like and share with your friends.